SpaceX's Starship has experienced more than a few crashes or explosions during uncrewed suborbital testing.
Starship!
Some more dramatic than others.
No!
On Monday, SpaceX ended up pushing off the first major flight of both stages of Starship due to what CEO Elon Musk called a frozen pressure valve.
We are going to stop the launch for today.
The road for testing and verifying that Starship can be operated and used the way SpaceX has set out to use it is long and hard.
Here are some of the challenges SpaceX faces getting its biggest and most powerful rocket off of and back on the ground. SpaceX has been developing Starship over the last several years, aiming to create a reusable rocket to one day handle ambitious crewed missions to deep space. The rocket is made up of a 226-foot-tall booster called Super Heavy that would power a 164-foot-tall spacecraft, also called Starship.
Super Heavy, the booster with the Starship spacecraft docked on top of it, that's never flown before. This is all brand new.
Musk has sought to temper expectations, telling listeners during a Twitter discussion that the company faces serious challenges pulling off the operation. Musk has pointed to Starship's engines as among his top concerns going into the flight attempt, at one point comparing them to grenades. The engines, called Raptors, were designed in-house at SpaceX. 33 are installed on the vehicle's booster.
The power that SpaceX has tried to build into the Super Heavy booster creates relatively more risk than, say, a smaller rocket with lesser engines that aren't designed to offer as much, you know, thrust, as much power to get to space.
Former employees have said risk-taking is encouraged at the company to gain data to make improvements, so long as that doesn't create safety risks.
The goal isn't to simply blow stuff up. The goal is to try to hit milestones, deal with anomalies and problems that may emerge, and make the vehicle better quickly.
Starship heading back to the landing zone.
SpaceX has also successfully landed the Starship spacecraft. On its fifth attempt, it landed back on its pad after climbing as high as 6.2 miles during a six-minute flight in 2021. If all goes to SpaceX's plan, the Starship spacecraft would fly around 90 minutes during the flight test after it separates from the booster. The booster would then land in the Gulf of Mexico, while the ship would land in the Pacific Ocean. But it will need to undergo some stress tests to get to that point.
If they're able to blast the rocket off, a minute after that, the vehicle will experience what's called max Q. It's basically the moment where there's the peak amount of mechanical stress on the rocket. If they get through that and the Starship spacecraft is able to separate and begin flying on its own, that's arguably the second big milestone in the mission.